Hello and welcome back to my channel. I hope we're all good. Next up today we have more Florence. Just like to say before I start the video, I've had quite a lot of comments, like saying like, "Oh, how do you not like this certain aspect of Florence's music? Like the which in particular is the high notes." Now, it's just my opinion. I personally don't think they're that good. But you don't. But the people in particular that seem to have a problem with that, it's just my opinion. You don't need to get so irate. If you do, then you must have a pretty boring life. So, just it's my opinion. Don't worry about it so much. I mean, we can have a debate about it. We don't. Well, it's not a debate because it's my opinion, but we can talk about it. But there's no need to get so like, "Oh my God, oh, his opinion isn't in the majority." So, it's just not really worth getting so worked up about. But anyway, next up in the Florence reactions, we have "What the Water Gave Me," which sounds like a cool title. So let's get into it. So I really like the start of the song. It had like a really like eerie like ding, like these little like plucks of noises maybe on the harp, and it's very eerie, but it definitely like set the scene because looking at what the song is about, it's about Florence's experiences when she was on the location of Virginia Woolf's suicide. So that definitely matches the lyrical content. But looking at the lyrics, it says here, "Time it took us to where the water was, that's what the water gave me." She says she uses water as a metaphor for life. She started off by saying all her life has been leading up to this, facing the water on. So like the total time it's taken her to where the water was, like all the stuff she's been doing has led up to that point, perhaps. Maybe that's what it means. I'm not entirely sure, but yeah, I like the start so far. And again, this is she's singing in like a stripped back, lower register kind of voice, and that suits her voice a million times better than the high notes. That's just my opinion. I like this, it's good. This is more like it. So again, looking at what is seen in the second verse, like obviously Atlas was left to carry the whole world, like the sky on his shoulders, and maybe she's linking that back to these stones, the like, well, like the weight of it, and obviously the stones like weighed her down and killed Virginia Woolf. I'm kind of getting the lyrical theme, but I'm not entirely sure just yet. Don't go high, don't go high. Good. Cymbals are way too loud in the mix. I can't. If I didn't know the lyrics, I couldn't distinguish what she was saying. So that's a production thing. It's not her.
Won't you have it any other way? You can't have any other way. Cause she's a cruel mistress, and the bargain must be made. But oh mama, don't forgive me.
For some reason she's kind of like contemplating the idea of sacrificing herself for loved ones, which is perhaps what Virginia Woolf did. Well, I'm not entirely sure about the story of like her background, but that might be what she's insinuating. Don't go high, don't go high. Good. Please, up high. Again, the instrumentation is way too loud in the mix. Like, her voice is like all the way back there. Like, it's kind of hard, it's really hard to hear. It's not hard to hear her voice, but it's hard to distinguish what she's saying. Yeah, this is a good song. See, why does she have to add that like those years in the end? It just doesn't, just pulls back. I just don't see the point. Like, what is the need for them? Like, this song is really good, but there's just no need for those years. It's just, I just realised, when she does those high notes, it sounds like a sheep. Like, yeah, it sounds like a sheep. Fade out. Gotta respect that. That would be it. That was What the Water Gave Me. That was definitely the best song I've heard by this band so far. Like, out of all of it, that is by far the best song. I love the vocal control. Like, I'm so glad. You can see me, I was like this. I'm so glad she didn't go for any of those high notes, because it just, to me, it just doesn't suit her voice. But I'm glad she like kept it quite like, she sang within her range, didn't stretch. I like do those horrible like sheep noises, which I'm sure people will kill me for, but bring it on. But that was a really good song. That was definitely the best. I like the lyrical content. I think she was kind of saying about like how the idea of sacrificing herself for her loved ones kind of like appeals to her. And maybe that's why Virginia Woolf did it. I'm not sure, I'll have to look into it and it'll probably make more sense. But yeah, that was good. Overall rating, I give it an 8.5 out of 10. So next up today, we have two more Dream Theater songs. I can't remember the titles, but they'll be up after this Florence reaction. So I'll see you soon.